Ngungani Orphanage and School is located in Kenya, Africa, a distance of 220 kilometers from Kenyan capital city Nairobi. The school is approximately 4 hours' drive from Jomo Kenyatta International Airport through Thika Mwingi Road. It's another new morning at Ngungani Orphanage, and community water vendors are delivering water for cooking and washing utensils. The children are up early to fetch water for their showers, while others help the cook, Madam Dorcas, in cleaning around the kitchen as she prepares porridge for breakfast. Siombua brings in firewood as a source of support to the orphanage, since she can't afford money to support her kid, who schools here.
My name is Pastor Peter from Kenya, Africa, and I am here in the village where I was born. The village is known as Ngungani Village. And here God spoke to me to start an orphanage and a school whereby I can help the kids.
Ngungani Orphanage and School was started in the year 2008 by Reverend Peter Mwendwa, who is the director. His main mission, to support the less fortunate and orphaned children in the village. Ngungani, the local village name, means a cave.
I want to welcome you to come and visit us. I want to welcome you to come and stay with our kids here. And really you will enjoy this place because the kids are very happy. If you see the photos and the videos, you will really enjoy this place, and your life will never remain the same when you come here.
Ngungani Orphanage and School opened its doors in 2008 with 24 orphans. Today, the orphanage has grown to 127 orphans and less fortunate kids, spreading from baby class to class 5.
We have some few challenges that we are really experiencing.
Despite the tremendous growth in number of orphans and needy kids at the orphanage, Ngungani Orphanage is faced with numerous challenges ranging from food, clothing, books, medicine, classrooms, dormitory, kitchen and dining hall, among others.
We give them uniforms, books, shoes. They don't buy anything. We need mattresses for them, enough food. We don't have desks, we don't have books. We don't have even kitchens. We don't have even chair to put the books. Remember, even books we don't have.
The main reason for increased orphans in the village is death caused by crocodile attacks, snake bites, HIV/AIDS, and also natural deaths. The other key challenge at the orphanage is feeding the kids. Lack of good kitchen amenities has affected the feeding program in a number of ways. For instance, when it rains, preparing food in this kind of kitchen is impossible, hence children end up sleeping hungry.
We are now starting to construct a kitchen.
Now where I am standing, you can see men on duty, on work, trying to prepare for the kitchen. Some of you, I know you know that I was raising money to buy bricks, and the bricks are down there. As you can see, so we are preparing the ground so that we may start the construction of the kitchen and our storeroom. You can see the bricks that we are trying. We are going to build the kitchen, the one that you saw. And behind the stones, you can see the whole kitchen. This is the whole kitchen. That's why we raised money to make sure we get a good and a permanent kitchen for the orphanage and the school here, Ngungani Orphanage. So we thank God for all the people who contributed towards buying these bricks. But still we are going to extend to see whether we can also put a dining hall where the kids they can eat when they are seated. So I request you to continue praying.
We need dormitories, to expand in dormitories, because more kids are coming.
Further, the orphanage is required to construct the remaining classes 7 and 8 to meet the Kenyan government requirements.
To construct classroom 6?
Yeah, class 6.
Okay.
And also another classroom there.
And there's another class?
Class 7.
And this is class 7 going
yeah.
up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then?
Then we go on. Still, we need to construct another class for class 8. Because in the government of Kenya, when we start a school, it has to go up to class 8.
Okay.
Yeah, so we need three classrooms right now.
Okay, so we need three more.
Yeah, three
so
more.
So if God can do nursery through class 5,
yeah,
he can do classroom 6, 7, and 8.
Yes.
Amen.
Teachers at the orphanage suffer a lot for lack of staff room and tables. They mark the books on their laps and do other office duties under a tree or on a veranda.
We don't have also the staff room for the teachers.
My name is Teacher Daisy. I've been teaching here in New Life Christian Education Center for 1.5 years. New Life is a good school, though we have our challenges as teachers. For instance, we have no staff room to sit when we are doing our things or when we are resting. We take our tea and lunch under a tree, and sometimes it is very challenging, especially because of bad weather, like when it rains.
Oh, what you see here in Ngungani, shout orphanage, it is because of faithful and people love this place. They have been donating and donating and donating, helping us to construct every building that is here, like 2 dormitories, classrooms, small office, a missionary house where you can come and stay. You can stay here for a year, 5 years, 2 years, 1 year. So welcome and experience live here in our orphanage. The kids, they will love you. The biggest challenge here is to pay teachers. I pay them very little. So please pray for us that every need is met here in our Ngungani orphanage. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. We are here today also celebrating with the widows. They have come. We support them. We give them food. Thank you so much. May God bless you so much. May the Lord bless you. Amen.